Welcome back, my dear students of class 8. Dear student, I am Rajendra Rai, your science teacher working at LPM Public School, Golabajar, Gorakhpur. My dear students, currently in this series of the video, you are going to learn about the chapter 15, that is from your prescribed book, and the name of the chapter is Light. What is light? Have you ever thought about it? कभी आपने सोचा है कि light क्या होती है, प्रकाश क्या होता है? Then you experience so many day to day you experience that in that there are days and there are nights. So in the night there is no light. In the day there is light, and the ultimate source of light is sun, bulb, tube lights. These are the ultimate source of lights. So during night, if light is absent, if sunlight is absent, tube light is also, if you put off, then you experience that nothing will be visible to your eyes. Now the question is that what thing facilitates us visibility? मतलब कि कौन सी ऐसी चीज है जिससे कि हमको दिखाई पड़ता है? Answer is, two types of objects are there. One is luminous, and the other is non-luminous. So luminous object is sun, which emits light. Non-luminous object is moon, which absorbs the light of sun and with the help of that absorbed light, sun glow. Okay. Therefore, we get the sensation of vision when this light reaches our eyes, and their images are processed in the brain. मतलब कि जब ये light पड़ती है आंखों में, तो जितनी भी इमेजेज रहती है, जिन जिन चीज़ों पर लाइट पड़ते हुए हमारे आंखों में पड़ती है, तो हमारा ब्रेन उस तरह से उसको रिसीव करता है. इन दिस कंसर्न देयर इज अनदर थिंग दैट इज द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट मीन्स the light get reflected. Two things are there, one is refraction and the reflection. So what is refraction? If you do an activity that you take a glass, then you put the light will be refract, light will be passed through that glass. Okay? Light will be able to pass the water, light will be passed through air. But if you put an object, make it pain on other side, that is a glass is painted on other side, then this light will return back
not reflection
two phenomena are there that are related to the light and object. Now, regular reflection and diffuse and irregular reflection. Okay, there are two types of reflection, regular reflection and irregular or diffuse reflection. So, regular reflection means
having a equal side, then this light will come and it will reflect. Light will come, it will reflect. Like this. So this is the ray diagram of reflection. This is the ray diagram of reflection.
Then this is the regular reflection and this is what gives rise to special image forming properties of the mirror. तो इसी के जरिए इसका image भी बनता है. Then diffuse reflection means
diffuse reflection means if the surface is rough, if the surface is rough, then there will be irregular reflection and like this, and so on.
Okay, so this is the diffuse reflection. My dear student, the rays which are coming to counter a surface are called incidence rays. And the rays which get returned back are called reflected rays. Incidence ray and reflected ray. And the point at which this ray counter, that will be called point of incidence. Then after incidence ray, reflected ray and point of incidence, and normal
means if a plane mirror is there, then if light is coming here, then the perpendicular axis is called normal. This will be the normal. This is the normal. But if light is coming from here, incidence and this will be the area of reflection. Angle I that will be equivalent to angle R. Angle I will be equivalent to angle R. So angle of reflection and angle of incidence. This is angle of incidence and this is angle of reflection. So dear students, these are the common thing which is related to the reflection with the plane mirror or with the rough surface, and you can do so many activities. Torch a light, light a torch and throw it on the plane mirror, then light will be reflected to another wall. So many activities that you can do at your home. My dear student, in this concern, I would like to highlight here about the several laws, and that is called law of reflection. This law of reflection is that number one, the incidence ray, the reflected ray and the normal at the point of incidence. Both the incidence rays and the reflected ray and the point of ray, the normal point of ray, that will be at a common point, that will be point of incidence. And the angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. Angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. So this is the law that is related to the reflection. And now, when the whole sheet of a paper is spread on the table, it represents one plane. The incidence ray, the normal at the point of incidence and the reflected ray are all in this plane. Okay? And plane in which the incidence ray and normal lie, we cannot see the reflected ray if we bring the paper back to the original position. Okay. Now come to the optical images. How does the images form? How does the images form from the plane mirrors? How does the images get formed by the plane mirror? And the image formed by the plane mirror, the characteristics of the image formed by the plane mirror. So, my dear student, there are two types of images. One is virtual and another is real. So, the mirrors, especially mirrors form, generally mirrors form, khaskar plane mirror form, virtual image.
that is abhasi, virtual, not real image. But the lenses form real image. Okay? So we will discuss about the real image. Real image is the rays of light is after reflection or refraction actually converge at a point, the image is said to be real. So jitni bhi rays hoti hai ek point par converge ho jati hai, like convex lens, aur usko bolte hai ki wo ek real image hai. You can touch that. Okay? But the virtual image, the rays do not actually meet after reflection, but appear, we meet when we produce backward. My dear student, I would like to explain you with the help of some more diagrams about the real image and virtual image. How does you can feel, how does you can learn the real image and virtual image by this diagram itself? So one diagram that will be, I think, helpful to all of you, that take a convex lens at your home. Okay, this is a convex lens and the rays are coming here, the rays will come here and they will pass the form of a small beam on the plain paper, and you can touch that image when the refraction takes place. Refraction is taking place, so this will be the real image. But if a plain mirror is there, then the rays are, suppose this is the object and the rays are coming to this is diverting, and the image will be formed here, something like this. So this will be the opposite side, this will be at the opposite side, and it will something like this, it will be like this, opposite side and at the same distance, but you cannot touch this. That is why it is called virtual image. तो आप इस virtual और इसको जो है आप समझने की कोशिश करें तो I think that will be better. So my dear students, I hope that this reflection light, image formation, incidence point of eye, point I, angle of I and angle of R, that you have understood it. And in the next video I will take the next topic, and that topic will be the image formation by the plane mirror, and it will be carried forward towards the other topics. So be careful and do what is needed at your home. One thing, my dear student, you have to do the learning. So learn this chart portion of this slide. I have already sent the very brief short notes on this. So you have to learn what I taught here on the board. Thank you. Good day.